they already have, the schools you're talking about, already have a huge advantage over us anyway. We get $1.3 million in TV, and they get 25 to 35, depending on which league you're in. So they have huge advantages already, and they've had huge advantages for a long time. The advantage is going to maybe be a little more, it's going to be a little bigger if they start giving stipends and we can't, and they can feed their kids 50 meals a day and we can only feed them three. The advantage might get a little bit bigger. It does not change the landscape. There's one rule that could, but it does not change the landscape. They have advantages. We know they have advantages. There's still a lot of high school football players out there. If you do a good job of evaluating talent and you coach them well and you get a group of guys together that mesh really well together and you get on a roll, you can have one of those years when you can beat them up. And if you get, like TCU did one year, you get to go to the Rose Bowl. Utah got to go to the Sugar Bowl and beat Alabama. TCU beat Wisconsin in the Rose Bowl. Boise State beat Oklahoma in the Fiesta Bowl. Now all of a sudden you get a $13 million or $14 million paycheck in your budget. And guess what? Now your program can start to get better and you become attractive to one of those other leagues. As long as they don't let them recruit off your campus, nothing has changed. And we will work to the point that we can beat those guys. If they allow them to transfer with no penalties, that could really hurt us. Because they see they have a need at running back. We have a freshman running back that's one of the best in the country. Legally or illegally, they will try to recruit him right off your campus if a kid can transfer and be immediately eligible.